First off is making sure your baton is the right measurement for you. Take the small under baton and place it underneath your armpit into tips of your fingers over top the end of the baton. If the tips of your fingers can hold it securely, but just hold it, it is the right size for you. If you have too small a baton, it will spin too quickly and you'll drop it. If you have too big a baton, it can run into your hips and hit into your arms while you're trying to twirl and you won't have a smooth twirling routine. How to hold your baton. Holding the baton is very important because you want to make sure it's securely in your hand to prevent drops or falls. Holding your baton is in your right or left hand, depending. Take your fingertips and pulling it towards your palm of your hand. Then taking your thumb and resting it on the pointer finger. Take your baton and do exactly what I just demonstrated, pulling the fingers into the palm and resting it on what would be the pointer finger on the baton bar. Now the motion of the baton is all between the thumb and the pointer finger. You want to have this motion, a circular motion around the pointer finger. The other fingers will help guide the baton in the direction you are twirling. Take your baton, pull the fingers to the palm, rest the thumb, make a circular motion, and have the other fingers guiding it into which direction you're going to twirl. Then you can do your horizontal twirl. Almost every routine has a horizontal twirl on it, and there's almost no tricks that don't require some kind of horizontal twirl. Next, you'll be learning how to do a vertical twirl. It's very similar to the horizontal twirl. A vertical twirl is in a different direction. A vertical twirl requires a lot of wrist motion. To do a vertical twirl, your wrist will go into a tail fin motion, going left, right, left, right, left, right. Using your thumb and your pointer finger to twirl the baton and other fingers to guide them. In the motion, this would be the motion of the fish's tail, and then using your pointer finger and your thumb to twirl the baton. Then you will get faster and close your fingers to help guide it. Next, you'll be learning how to do a two-handed spin. This requires both hands on the baton. You want to take your one hand on your baton and spin it up towards the other hand, crossing your hands, grabbing the baton this way, returning it to the thumb and pointer finger of your right hand. It should look like this. Next, you'll be learning how to do rolls. Rolls is taking your baton and rolling it off a limb to create a trick. Rolls are very important routines. The most commonly used roll is between the fingers, known as the fingers trick. You want to take it between your thumb and your pointer finger, grasping it, pushing your thumb over your pointer finger pushing it over your middle finger pushing it over your pinky finger, and onto the pinky finger. Done in a faster motion would look like this. Straight throws is where you take the end of your baton and go in circular motion. You can do different kinds of straight throws. Straight arm throws, which are like this, or ones that require your wrist. It is a very simple move and can add a lot of style to your routine. You can put all these moves together to make one routine. Your horizontals, your verticals, your rolls, your straight throws, your rolls again, your two-handed spins, and your fingers.